I'm all in your grill so you can see the real. AA. What's up, good people? AKA winners. That's all we do. Hey, that's all we do. I'm coming to you with another video. Hey, coming to you with another video. Vicky. Hey. And I'm super duper excited because I'm always excited when I film. I have a little situation right now. Like, I've been slacking a little bit on this quarantine on my face. So, like, just, we're focusing on the eyes, okay? And that's all I'm gonna do for this video. But what I will do is I will put in the description box all of the things that I'm using on my face, just in case you guys wanna know. Let me say this, sis, check on your friends during this quarantine, the ones that have these braids, baby, because some of us are not okay. Listen, beauty supplies closed, okay? So we gotta make it do what it do, and the bun works, and we got to get that slickage popping, so that's why we have this on. And then before I get started, I'm gonna show you the image, the eye look that I'm gonna be doing that was highly requested on Instagram and in my inboxes. And but before I do that, I do want to let you know that you have the ability to join the fam bam, okay? By clicking that subscribe button, it gets you in. And guess what? It's free 99. Come on in here and join this fam bam and let us love on you. I'm just saying. But click subscribe and then personalize your notifications, because I think it will automatically assume that you want it customized by them, meaning that they tell you when you're gonna get my notification. Just saying. This is my Instagram page. It is CKey_beauty, but there you go. Wait, should I do? There you go. Right there. This is the look that we are going to be that's cute, girl. This is the look that we're going to be doing. And it's really like a semi cut crease. So this is the look that I do when I want it to look like I did a whole lot, but I really didn't. But it's just really bomb and it's really natural. But I'm looking for my stuff, girl. What I did already was I used my Too Faced Born This Way multi-use sculpting concealer. This is in the shade Chestnut. I put it all over my whole lid to mute out any discoloration. And then I set it with a powder, which I didn't want to waste your time with that. I set it with this powder, which is Urban Decay Stay Naked The Fix in 70WY. And then for my brows, none other, because it's a love thing, it's the Ofra Brow Gel, and it is in dark brown. They changed the packaging, but yeah, I can't live without it. I can't live without you. I can't breathe without you. I love that stuff, I'm just saying. But what we're gonna start with, I believe this is the shade that I started with, but we can always adjust it if need be. But this is the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe collaboration, the Vault palette. This one is Ring the Alarm. And as you can see, this shade right here, I love it. It's called Mugshot, but I say, Mugshot, hey, diggy diggy, come on. Y'all know that, okay? So I'm gonna go into this brush. What is this? This is the Morphe E22. And I am going to put this in the crease before I lay a base down. And really, people are like, is that cut crease? It's like a semi-cut crease because I don't do it all across the all across my crease. I just kind of like to have this angle look, if you will. You saw it in the picture. And so I am just going to put this in the crease all the way around. And I'm gonna do that, like what you do unto one, you do unto other to the other. I don't know how long this video is going to be, but I want to do it step by step so that you guys can get like the gist of what I'm doing here and you can understand and you can practice it yourself. But I am gonna tell you right now that blending is key, y'all. You can't just throw it on there and leave it. All right, but it's really simple, and all you have to do, when I put on my shadow in the crease, I literally do it in windshield wiper motions, right? And I start right here in this little socket, okay? I start right here, and then I do circular motions, but here's the thing. I hold it like not quite up here and not all the way at the end, but maybe like midway. That way I don't put a lot of pressure, okay? Because some of you guys, you may do it too hard. You may be heavy-handed. You don't have to do that. Just lightly dust it on, and if you want more color, simply put more on your brush, dap it a little bit so it doesn't, you know, It's not a whole bunch of like powdery stuff coming on, not a bunch of fallout, if you will. And then just windshield wiper motions. And also another reason that you may have blending problems, if you have blending problems, is simply because you may not put a base on and then put a little bit of shadow on it. Well, I use my foundation and that stops, you know, shadows from skipping. It allows me to blend it smoothly and seamlessly. So that's why, well, the concealer I put on to mete out the discoloration, but then I put that powder on to set it. I don't put it on this mobile lid right here though, because I am about to put this base on there and I didn't want it to be really cakey. So I just let the concealer do what it do, but I did put my powder in the crease and over here so that it can blend smoothly. This right here is the LA Girl Pro HD Primer, High Definition Eyeshadow Primer. I think this is in the shade Nude or something. I'm not sure, but anyway, I love it. I think I'm kind of running out of it, but you know, as you use it more and more, like the precision, like I've kind of worn it out. So what I do, we'll do one eye first and then I'll do the other one off camera. So what I do is I take this stick and I go up here. Now the reason that I put it up this high, you may not have to do that, but I do this and I don't wanna say fake it till I make it, cause you know, my eye's not gonna change and we're not getting any work done, okay? We've established that. So I just go higher so that it appears that I have more lid space than I do, all right? So then I take my finger and I blend that out, and sometimes you go over the line. If you want to be extremely precise, then you want to put some of that on like a brush and then, you know, and then put it on so that you're extremely precise. But, you know, a low maintenance girl, and I just, you know, do my best. And then if it's not exactly how I want it to be, then I go over that again and make it clean. So you can use a brush to make that like all the way perfect, but anyway. And then I don't like it. I like this to have that angle right there. So I just blend that down. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that brush again and we're gonna take that shade and I'm just gonna put it a little more right here for where I messed up, okay? And then we're gonna do like that. And so far this is what you should have, okay? And there may be a little creasing. That's why you want to take that finger and you want to dab it off before you put that shadow on. You want to dab, a dib a dab, a do yet, okay? So you wanna dab that a little bit, right? And then I just, again, and then you can perfect this when it's all done. Like what I tend to do is to make sure that everything is lined up the same, I will close my eyes and take a picture and then I'll look at the picture and then if I need adjustments, I'll make it. And that's how I get it perfect when I'm going to, you know, post a picture, because the real talk, just looking like this, sometimes it's not as even as I think it is. I take a smaller brush that looks like this right here. I don't even know what this, oh, this is a Morphe one too. This is the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe brush. This is, what is it, girl? JH41. Now this shade, I'm not sure what the shade is. So you wanna get a shade that you want to use. Whether you want a little more brown in it, whether you want something that's a little more creamy. I think that this is ColourPop Running Late. That's what I think that is, and I'm not sure if they still have it, but you can use similar colors, right? You can use this color, I think is Makeup Geek right here, Makeup Geek Peach Smoothie, but it is a little too light. I like mine to have a little bit of golden in there. You can use this one, that which is a little bit darker, if you want it to be more brown. It's up to you in the natural look that you're going for. Let me see what the name of this one is. This is actually, this is ColourPop too. This is a mixture of ColourPop and Makeup Geek. So this one is ColourPop Note to Self. And then I simply pat it like so. And I dab it. And then I take, the reason I like this smaller brush is because it's gonna get in the, right there in the little crevices that I want it to. And I have more control over it because it's smaller and it has a little bit of a point to it. And so it allows me to be more detailed. So this is when I want, I told y'all, when I want to do a detailed look, I can. And so I'm simply placing the shadow everywhere that I place the base. And the detail really doesn't come until after I add my wing liner and after I add my lashes. But I'm not gonna do that on camera because I have a whole video where I show you how to do that. So I'm not good, cause baby, I need two fingers and I need two hands, like all hands are on deck, and I'm not gonna even take y'all through that. You just got to check that video out, okay? Now, I'm just gonna be honest and real cause y'all know I don't know no other way to be, but this is the 3502 palette and this is the shade Universal that I love. I believe that this new palette that I got, I feel like this color is different. I think that the other palette I had was a little more yellow. I feel like this one gives me a little more orange, but that could just be me. But listen, it's not as bomb as what it was, but I still like it. It's still one of my fave brow bone highlights, but I believe the other one was a little more yellow. But anyway, so I take this with a Dollar Elf brush, girl. Listen, as long as your brush gets you right, it doesn't matter the price you pay. Like, I love e.l.f. brushes. I love Real Technique. I love Morphe. I love MAC. It's just, you know, whatever brush gets the job done. I don't discriminate on brushes and I don't discriminate on makeup. After we have done that, here is where we do the detailed look. Now, I recommend that you don't do no baby girl lashes, okay? That you put your grown folk lashes on. Now, what I have on, I believe these are Ardell 213s with 778. Always mix it up. 778, 774. Oh, I think it's 778. All right, I'll put the link in the description box. Now, what we're gonna do since we've done that is we are going to take our handy dandy palette, you know, the Makeup Geek and the ColourPop. We're gonna take that again, but this time you are going to take this is a detailed brush. It is a blending brush. Well, not a detail brush. Let me retract that statement. It is actually a small blending brush. And the reason I like to use that is because that is where I do the detail work. Now, it looks way more than what it is, I promise y'all. But we're gonna go into this Americano by Makeup Geek, which is one of my faves for deepening up that crease. And the reason I call this a semi-cut crease is because I'm only going to do right here because I like that angle. This is like my signature look. And a lot of times this is the look that I do when I go to events. So I just simply placed that right there. Did you see? Like literally, almost like little to no effort. And I like to do the lashes and do the liner because it carves it out. It kind of gives me an outline. And so I don't go too heavy. And I like that color because it's not quite black, but it's not like super brown. Like it gives the appearance or the illusion that it's almost like a black. Cause black to me would be a little too deep, right? And I take it like around there. I give it that angle, you see that? It's almost like a slant and I like that. I do not have to have the full cut crease because sometimes if you have that full cut crease, it can look a little harsh. And I just like it to look like, well, dang, she know what she doing. Oh, well, whoa, okay, that's cute. And then what I do is I go with my blending brush and I kind of blend around that so that that's not harsh. And I may put a little more color on it. And then two, wipe it off a little bit so that that darkness is not fully on the brush. And then blend it right here so that it doesn't look like you just placed it right there and then you stop. Like, what the heck are you doing, right? You do want it to have that airbrushed effect. So this is why sometimes people's makeup looks, they'll look good, but then it'll be like, yo, something happened there though. Like you kind of stopped like halfway. Like what happened? And sometimes I have to do my wing. I have to fill that in a little bit more again because I put a little shadow on it and it kind of dulls it out. But I don't mind doing that because it helps me to know where I want to place this, right? It just looks better. And so I'm just getting this color again, the mugshot, and I'm blending that out. We want all that detail to be right there in that corner. And then I'm going to put a little liner right there too that's going to help with the detail watch. I am going to take a liner, and my liner, this is the MAC Feline Kohl. And I'm just going to take a little bit right here. Boom, just to give it a little depth, right? I didn't do a whole lot, just right there. And then if you want to take a little bit of brown shadow under there, you can, but I think I'm going to opt out. But once I get the foundation on, I'll let you guys know. So this is the final look, and this is when you have applied everything. You got your highlight, you got your foundation, all that good stuff. I will put all of that in the description box, you guys, but this is the final look on the eyes. Again, I have not taken a picture to see if it's all even, but you guys get the gist of it. I hope that I was able to help you guys. This look can be worn for for a formal event, a casual day, like on the weekend. It can even be considered an everyday look. Like you can just minus the deepness there, and this can be like your everyday look. And then you could just step it up by adding that little semi cut crease, as I call it, because this is not really like a cut crease, but this is my signature look. It's my signature look when I go to speaking engagements. It's my signature look when I go to events. It's my signature look when I just want to step up that natural because I want a little oomph. But if you guys recreate this look, pretty please tag me on Instagram at @ckey_beauty, or you can post it on my Facebook page, which is CKey Beauty. I want you guys to feel comfortable with interacting with me on social media as well. So make sure that you tag me because I definitely want to see. But I love you guys so much. You guys are thebomb.com. You are amazing. Okay. So have an awesome, blessed day, and I will see you sooner than you think. Deuces. CKey Beauty, confidence is key. You know what I mean? A woman feels good when she's looking pretty.